Natalie Portman, who? Yes, she was all like, I don't want to be in your shitty movies, Marvel. And they're like, fine, we're just going to go and assemble the greatest single cast ever for a Marvel film in terms of like people that they're bringing on that are new, right? Like occasionally they have a cool new add-on or a cameo, but this is like major roles and major actors joining the Marvel Cinematic Universe. You know, I said the other day that with all the negative reviews that were coming in for some of the competing comic book films, that maybe we would be entering a period where name actors wouldn't want to be in these films, right? Where they're like, holy crap, like James McAvoy all of a sudden is like, I've got like a really bad movie on my resume, apparently, at least according to the reviews. But I guess it's just funneling everyone towards Marvel, and they're like, they're the only consistent game in town, and I'd like a boost to my career, because interestingly enough, when people, actors star in these movies, they get more fans, and then the fans have a more of an interest in what they do outside of the MCU. Except for Chris Hemsworth and Chris Evans. Well, actually, also to some degree, I don't know how much of a crossover there is. You know, Macbeth with Michael Fassbender didn't do particularly well. So we'll see. We'll see. It's really interesting. But boy, what a cast. Kevin Feige. He really outdid himself on this one. This is just absolutely stellar. I wouldn't be surprised if there's just a little pang of regret somewhere inside Natalie Portman being like, maybe I made a mistake. I could have been Lady Thor. Well, she just called Thor. Thank you very much. But she could have maybe been that if she hadn't quit. All right, so let's go over this cast, and then you can marvel at how incredibly awesome it is. And boy, if anyone needed some luck, it was Chris Hemsworth after The Huntsman: Winter's War. I thought he was very good in that movie, but this is just absolutely shocking. All right, so we knew that Cate Blanchett was going to be in the movie, and we kind of knew she was going to play Hela, but that is now confirmed. And there's this awesome concept art where you can see her headdress, you know, that's Hela from the back coming to Asgard, and she's really a cool character. You know, I just spoke today about female villains in, you know, comic book movies, and in particular in Marvel, because they're the ones who just got in trouble for Shane Black revealing that they said no to a female villain in Iron Man 3. But I guess they're cool with it now. I guess if it's played by Cate Blanchett and she gets to wear that amazing costume, it's okay. And that is okay. I mean, who wouldn't be behind that? But so they finally have one. I think that's going to be really exciting. And if you saw her in Cinderella, you know how good a job she can do. Not only as a villain, but when she gets to have this amazing armor that is an amazing glamorous costume. So she's going to be absolutely spectacular. She's playing the goddess who oversees the Asgardian underworld. So expect a couple characters to die during this movie, but not go away, because they will just then be trapped in hell, run by Hela, and Thor and company will have to go get them. So that's going to be fantastic. She's going to be a little Maleficent-like, I would imagine, actually, come to think of it. Angelina Jolie's got some competition. Next up, this was a real shocker, Jeff Goldblum. Now, I've really enjoyed Jeff Goldblum, not only in his Apartments.com commercials, or whatever that's for, right? But also, I thought he had some really good lines in the Independence Day resurgence trailers, when he's like, they love the landmarks. I was like, that's a good line. And of course, everybody, when Jurassic World came around, even though Jeff Goldblum is not in the movie and wasn't in Jurassic Park 3, you know, of course, everybody went back to his famous lines. So he's going to play somebody called the Grandmaster. Now, this is a cosmic being, and we heard rumors that part of Thor Ragnarok will take place in space, a little bit of a space road trip. But now we're going to get a little better idea with this character being included. But of course, we have to move towards Infinity War. And what do you know, Jeff Goldblum's Grandmaster has a history with the Infinity Gems. He used to have the Mind Gem, but of course, that stuck smack in the middle of Vision's forehead. So I guess he will get one of the ones that are still up for grabs. But with this guy does is he likes to play games with characters, right? Which is interesting because Jeff Goldblum's so eccentric, and this kind of character is very eccentric, that it reminds me a lot of Benicio del Toro's The Collector, and they seem a little bit like they cancel each other out, so I'll be interested to see how they can make that work. But anyway, I wouldn't be surprised if he challenges Thor and Hulk to a game, and maybe works with Hela, we'll see. And also Loki loves games, so it's an interesting character to include. Indeed. Then we have Tessa Thompson, confirmed as Valkyrie. This was a rumor going around the other day, aka Broomhilda, and it has now been confirmed. And she leads the Valkyrie, and that is a group of female Valkyries, and it's basically the Amazons of Asgard. Perhaps Marvel saw how popular Wonder Woman was in Batman v Superman, and they were like, we could do that, and we could even do it even better with making it a woman of color. This is a change of ethnicity for the character, and Tessa Thompson is coming off of Creed, where she did a really spectacular job. She was also in Dear White People, but I think Creed is where most people know her from. I'll be curious to see how she does, but this is a really big deal for not only Marvel, but comic book movies. All right, so next, Karl Urban. Wow, that just kind of makes the whole thing. Everybody loves Karl Urban. Well, actually, not everybody does love Karl Urban. That's why his career constantly struggles. But man, does he have a cult fan base, particularly in the same community that likes Marvel movies. If you have not yet seen Dread, watch Dread. Karl Urban is just fantastic there. He's also, of course, known as Bones in the new Star Trek movies, but he's just really a good actor. He also did a pretty good job on the recent TV show, Almost Human, with Michael Ealy. He was very good there as well, although Michael Ealy did steal the show from him there. But anyway, here he'll be playing a character called Skurge, and this is an Asgardian warrior who in the comics is in love with Enchantress, who is one of Thor's villains and also one of Thor's love interests. Thor gets around. But I would imagine perhaps here they'll retcon it to make it so that Hela is the one that manipulates him. So he's in love. I think Karl Urban being in love with Cate Blanchett makes perfect sense. And so she's able to manipulate him to do her bidding because she's like, I'll like you and, you know, give you a sexy death kiss if you go beat up Thor for me. And he's like, okay. Also, he has a history of being manipulated by Loki. So Skurge, not the brightest bulb in the bunch, but I think if he's... Also, Karl Urban, though, always comes across to me as somewhat, you know, of an intelligent person, so we'll see if he can pull that off, but I would love to see Karl Urban and Chris Hemsworth fight. That would be just absolutely amazing, right? So that's fantastic. Then, of course, Mark Ruffalo's Hulk, aka Banner, will also be in the movie. It's just an embarrassment of riches. Like, this is an amazing cast. How will they have time for everyone to get screen time? So it's almost like the Asgardian Avengers to some degree. It's that full of star power. So he's going to be there. Although it looks like they're not doing Planet Hulk at all, it would seem, in this with this cast. So we'll see how this works. Perhaps, you know, I would hate to see the Grandmaster manipulate Hulk yet again, right? I mean, we already saw that happen with Scarlet Witch and Avengers Age of Ultron. I would like Mark Ruffalo's Banner to, you know, voluntarily be a part of this adventure. And then maybe he ran off last we saw him, and perhaps he was like, Thor's like, come on, come with me, bro. Come to Asgard for a while. Drown your sorrows in some mead. Then, of course, confirmed to return are Chris Hemsworth as Thor. He's like, woohoo, I'm in the middle of all this. This is so great for me. Tom Hiddleston is Loki, thank goodness, just because I'm like on the edge of being done with Tom Hiddleston, because he was really bad in I Saw the Light, the Hank Williams Sr. movie, and he was really bad in The Night Manager. I don't know how much more I can take of like bland Tom Hiddleston. I need him to remind me why I liked him in the first place. So he'll be coming back. Idris Elba is Heimdall. He's one of the people rumored to die. I just would like to see Idris Elba get to do something cool in a Marvel movie. That would be nice. And then Anthony Hopkins is also confirmed to return as Odin, although don't forget, currently Loki is masquerading as Odin in Asgard. So we'll see what happens there. They did not mention the Warriors 3, which I'm okay with. I mean, also, there's no room for the Warriors 3 with this cast. And also, who would tell this cast to go sit on the bench so the Warriors 3 can get in the game? That would be ridiculous. I think the Warriors 3 are good in the comics, but they've never really worked in the movies, and I don't think they're necessary. And then the director, of course, is Taika Waititi, who is from What We Do in the Shadows, who's worked with Jermaine Clement on that, and he actually comes from a comedic background, so I think that could make for some really fantastic dialogue and interplay between these characters, which would be really nice. We'll see how he handles the action. There's always a learning curve with these things, and I always get nervous when someone gets to cut their teeth on a big movie, right? It's like, go do your training somewhere else. But I'm sure that Marvel will support him. It would be kind of hard to fail with this cast, in my opinion. So what do you think? Do you think this is a good cast? I mean, do you agree with me it's the best standalone single cast yet that Marvel's been able to do? And do you think this is a direct result of Marvel's win at the box office, that they can now make these kind of calls, get these actors on board. We'll see. I think Guardians of the Galaxy 2 is shaping up pretty good with Sharon Stone rumored to be in there. Sylvester Stallone, Kurt Russell. I mean, wow. Wow, that's really amazing. That's pretty nice. The Marvel sandbox is awfully attractive these days. All right, write your thoughts down below, and you can check out some other episodes right now.